Hey guys, what's up? This is Serge and welcome back to my channel for another Final Cut Pro tutorial. Today, we'll learn how to add the freeze frame character intro effect inspired by the opening credits of the movie Snatch. Let's jump right into Final Cut Pro and see how we can do this. Skim the clip in your timeline and place your skimmer over the frame you want to use for your freeze frame. Press Option F on your keyboard to create a freeze frame of your selected frame and ripple trim it to the desired length. Let's do about 3 seconds. Select your clip, hold down the Option key, and drag up to make a copy of your selected clip. Select your bottom clip and press V to disable it for now. What we need to do next is isolate our subject from the background, and for that, we'll use the Draw Mask tool. Open the Effects browser, and in the search bar at the bottom, type in Draw Mask. Grab the Draw Mask effect, and drag it over and apply it to your top clip. With the top clip selected, in the inspector, change the shape type to B-spline. So instead of straight lines and sharp corners between our control points, we'll get smooth, curved lines. This tends to work way better for outlining people. Zoom in on your viewer and add control points to outline your subject. Take your time here and be as accurate as possible. If you need to make a sharp corner in your mask, you can change the shape type of individual control points. Right-click on your control point and select Linear. Keep adding control points to outline your entire subject. In my example, there's a few stray hairs which would be impossible to isolate, so I find it works best if you just leave them out of the mask, but try to keep the overall shape of the hair. Using the B-spline shape type here will keep your mask looking realistic so you don't have a bunch of sharp corners here. Once your entire subject is outlined, click on the original control point to close your mask. Next, let's add an outline to our subject to separate her from the background. Final Cut Pro does not come with an outline effect, but you can either use a plugin for this, such as the outline effect from BradFX, or use the feather tool in your mask for this. Hold down the Option key and drag up on your top clip to make another copy of it. With your bottom clip selected, in the inspector, select the Color tab. In the exposure controls, drag your global exposure puck all the way up to 100%. If we disable our top clip, you can see this turns our entire subject white. I'll re-enable my top clip. Select the bottom clip again, and in the inspector, go back to the video inspector. In the mask section, drag your falloff slider all the way up to 100%, and move the feather slider to around 30 to give our subject a nice white outline. Select both your top clips, and press Option G on your keyboard to combine them into one compound clip. With your compound clip selected, select the Color Inspector, and from the drop-down menu, select Color Curves. First thing we want to do is bring down the saturation in all three color channels. Grab the top control point on the red channel and drag it all the way down. Repeat this for the green and blue channels. Next, grab the Shadows control point on the Luma channel and drag it to the right to crush the shadows. Drag the Highlights control point to the left to blow out the highlights. You can also add control points anywhere on this line and adjust them until your image looks just the way you want it to. Right about there looks good. Next, let's re-enable a bottom clip and add a generator between our two layers. Open the Titles and Generators browser, and from the Generators drop-down menu, select the Backgrounds category. I think the organic generator will fit in good in this clip, so let's grab it and drag it into our timeline between the two layers. Ripple trim it to the same length as your freeze frame clips, and add cross dissolve transitions to each side to fade it in and out. Ripple trim the transitions to about 7 frames long. Here's what we have so far. With our generator covering our bottom layer, let's animate the position and scale of our subject. Select the top layer, and with the playhead at the start of your clip, click the Transform button at the bottom of the viewer window, and add a keyframe here by clicking the Keyframe button in the top left corner. Move your playhead ahead about 20 frames, and reposition and resize your subject to make room for a title. We'll set the scale to about 120%, move it to the left side of the screen, and add a bit of rotation. And for our last step, let's add and animate some text. Move your playhead back to the start of your clip, and in the search bar of the Titles and Generators browser, type in Basic. click and drag the basic title down into your timeline between the top two clips. Ripple trim it to the desired length. Select your top clip and press Ctrl-V to show video animation. Place your playhead on the second set of keyframes where the subject is in her final position. Select your title clip, enter your title text, and adjust the font, size, and appearance of your title. Move your playhead ahead another 20 frames, and in the video inspector, add keyframes to all your transform parameters. Move back 20 frames, zoom out on your viewer window, hit the transform button, and move your title off screen. You can also adjust the rotation of your title to make it rotate as it comes on screen. Let your clip render out, and this is your finished result. Thanks again for watching, and if you enjoyed this video, make sure to check out the rest of my channel for more like it. New videos uploaded weekly, so make sure to subscribe. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you back here next week.